Hi everyone, welcome back to PharmaChem Insights. I am Irfan Sheikh. Today we are diving into something really important if you are preparing for a role in pharmaceutical or analytical chemistry. HPLC method development interview question and answers. If you are aiming for a job where HPLC is a key part of the work, these are questions you need to know. So let's get started. First question. What is the principle of HPLC? HPLC or High Performance Liquid Chromatography separates components in a mixture based on their interaction with the stationary phase and mobile phase. Different compounds move through the stationary phase at different rates, leading to separation. The more an analyte interacts with the stationary phase, the slower it moves through the column. The mobile phase flows continuously, carrying the analytes along, which allows the separation of the compounds based on factors like polarity, size, or charge. Let's move on to next question. What are the main components of an HPLC system? The main components of an HPLC system include, you can see in this diagram, mobile phase reservoir, pump, injector, column, detector, and data system. So first is solvent reservoir, which is also called as mobile phase reservoir. It is a glass bottle that contains the mobile phase. Second is pump, which delivers the mobile phase at a constant flow rate. Third is injector. It introduces the sample into the mobile phase. Fourth is column. It is also called as the heart of the HPLC system. It is packed with stationary phase material such as C18 silica where actual separation occurs. Fifth is detector. It detects the separated components as they elute from the column. Example, UV visible detector, PDA detector or MS detector, mass spectroscopy detector. Sixth is data system. It records and processes the detector signal to produce a chromatogram. The next important question is, how do you develop an HPLC method for a new compound? So for method development for a new compound involves several steps. First is understanding the properties of the compound, that is chemical structure, solubility, polarity and pKa of the compound. Second is choosing the right column. Depending on the nature of the analyte, you have to choose the column. Example, C18 column for non-polar compounds. Third is selecting the mobile phase. First begin with a trial mobile phase, commonly a mixture of water and organic solvents like acetonitrile. You can replace acetonitrile with methanol. Fourth is adjusting parameters, that is modify your pH, your gradient elution, flow rate or temperature to optimize separation. Next is trial and error. Test different conditions to evaluate peak shape, your retention time and resolution. Next is validation. Ensure method reproducibility, linearity, accuracy and robustness to validation experiments. Here is a key question that often asks, how do you select the mobile phase for HPLC? The choice of mobile phase depends on the nature of the analyte and the stationary phase. Factors to be include. Polarity. In reverse phase HPLC, which is the most common, usually start with polar solvents like water mixed with organic solvents such as acetonitrile or methanol. Next is pH. Adjusting the pH of the mobile phase can help with the ionization of acidic or basic analytes, improving separation and peak shape. Next is solvent strength. A stronger solvent helps elute analytes more quickly but may reduce resolution. Next is solvent compatibility. The mobile phase must be compatible with the detector Example, UV transparency for UV visible detection. Next is gradient elution. A gradient mobile phase may also be used where the composition of the solvent changes over time, improving separation for complex mixtures. Now let's cover column back pressure. You might be asked, what is column back pressure in HPLC and how do you manage it? Back pressure is the pressure that builds up when the mobile phase passes through the column. High back pressure can damage the column or reduce the separation efficiency. To manage it, use a smaller particle size stationary phase for better resolution but increase the pressure limit. Reduce flow rate if the pressure exceeds the system's limit. Use a shorter column or one with a larger inner diameter to reduce pressure. Ensure the mobile phase is properly filtered to avoid clogging the column. Another essential question, how do you validate an HPLC method? Validation ensures that the HPLC method produces reliable and reproducible results. Key validation parameters include precision. It is repeating the analysis multiple times to check consistency. Accuracy. This test is done to see how close the measured value is to the true value. Linearity. It ensures the response is proportional to the analyte concentration over a given range. Next is limit of detection, LOD. This determines the lowest concentration of analyte that can be detected. Next is limit of quantification, that is LOQ. This determines the lowest concentration that can be quantified with acceptable precision and accuracy. Next is specificity. It ensures that the method can distinguish the analyte from other substances. And last is robustness. It tests how resistant the method is to small changes in conditions like pH, flow rate, and temperature. Now let's cover the detectors. What are the common detectors used in HPLC and how they work? Common HPLC detectors include UV visible detector, photodiode array PDA detector, fluorescence detector, mass spectrometer MS detector, refractive index RI detector. UV visible detector. It measures the absorption of analytes at specific wavelength. It's widely used for compounds with chromophores like aromatic rings. Next is photodiode array PDA detector. It is similar to UV visible but can scan across a range of wavelengths simultaneously, giving more information about the compound's spectral properties. Next is fluorescence detector. Highly sensitive for compounds that naturally fluoresce or can be derivatized to fluorescence. Next is mass spectrometer MS detector. It provides detailed information about the molecular weight and structure of the analyte, often used for identifying unknown compounds. Last is refractive index RI detector. It measures changes in the refractive index of the mobile phase used for compounds that do not absorb UV light. Next question, how will you optimize an HPLC method? Optimization involves optimizing following parameters, that is mobile phase composition, adjusting the solvent ratio or adding modifiers like buffers or acids to improve peak shape and retention time. Flow rate. Slowing down the flow rate can improve resolution but increases runtime. Column temperature. Increasing the temperature can reduce retention times and improve peak shape, but it may also affect resolution. Next parameter, injection volume. Ensuring that the sample size is appropriate to avoid overloading the column, which can lead to poor peak shape. Next parameter, gradient or isocratic elution. For complex mixtures, a gradient elution, that is changing solvent composition over time often improves separation. Next question, what factors affect resolution in HPLC? There are several factors that influence the resolution in HPLC. First is column efficiency. Higher column efficiency results in better separation. Column efficiency is measured in theoretical plates. Next is flow rate. Higher flow rates can reduce resolution as there is less time for separation. Next is particle size. Smaller stationary phase particles generally lead to better separation but higher back pressure. Next question. What is reverse phase HPLC and why is it commonly used? Reverse phase HPLC is the most commonly used type of HPLC. In this method, the stationary phase is non-polar, typically a C18 column with hydrophobic alkyl chains, and the mobile phase is polar, typically water or a mixture of water and an organic solvent like acetonitrile or methanol. The separation is based on the hydrophobic interaction between the non-polar analytes and the stationary phase. Reverse phase HPLC is widely used because most pharmaceutical compounds are hydrophobic or semipolar, making it ideal for their separation. And that wraps up our look at some common HPLC method development interview questions. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. Drop any question you have in the comments and I will be happy to answer them. Good luck with your interviews and I will see you in the next video.